Hey everyone, it is great to have you back with me today for this stimulus update. On this episode, we will be taking a look at a portion of the Nancy Pelosi and Wolf Blitzer interview from yesterday. If you've seen it already, you need to see it again, and I will give you my perspective on what happened there. If you have not seen it already, brace yourself. This was something else. In addition, both Nancy Pelosi and Steven Mnuchin have met up again today to continue the stimulus negotiations. Both camps have weighed in on today's meetings. We're going to share with you what they said right after this. Once again, welcome back to your stimulus update for today, Wednesday, October 14th. We are going to jump right into the Nancy Pelosi Wolf Blitzer interview that occurred yesterday and has gone viral. Wolf Blitzer was interviewing her specifically about the stimulus, and throughout the interview, she was unbelievably frustrated with the line of questioning, and her answers go ahead and show that. You need to see this for yourself. I will share with you my thoughts afterwards.
They really need the money right now. And even members of your own...
I understand that, but
your, but even members
if you
of
ask
your
me
own
a question,
caucus, even members of your own caucus, Madam Speaker, want to accept this deal. $1.8 trillion, Congressman Ro Khanna, for example.
But let me just
quote Ro Khanna, a man you know well. I assume you admire him. He's a Democrat. And he just said this. He said, people in need can't wait until February. $1.8 trillion is significant and more than twice the Obama stimulus. Make a deal, put the ball in McConnell court. So what do you say to Ro Khanna?
What I say to you is, I don't know why you're always an apologist, and many of your colleagues, apologists for the Republican position. Ro Khanna, that's nice. That isn't what we're going to do, and nobody's waiting till February. I want this very much now, because people need help now. But it's no use giving them a false thing just because the president wants to put a check with his name on it in the mail, that we should not be doing all we can to help people pay the rent, put food on the table, to enhance benefits, that they don't lose their jobs if they're state and local. We're talking about the consequences of a pandemic, that the symptoms of a problem that the president refuses to address.
But you know,
and that is,
Madam
and
Speaker,
that is the coronavirus.
We know
that is
we
the
know
coronavirus.
The problem out there, but there are millions of Americans who have lost their jobs. They can't pay the rent. Their kids need the food.
That's right. And that's what we're trying to get done.
$1.8 trillion. And the president just tweeted, stimulus, go big or go home. He wants even more right now. So why not work out a deal with him? And don't let the perfect, as they say here in Washington, be the enemy of the good.
Well, I will not let the wrong be the enemy of the right.
What's wrong with $1.8 trillion?
Well, you know what? Do you have any idea what the difference is between the spending that they have in their bill and that we have in our bill? Do you realize that they have come back and said all these things for child tax credits and earned income tax credits or helping people who have lost their jobs are eliminated in their bill? Do you realize they pay no respect to the fact that child care is very important for people whose children cannot go to school because they're doing remote learning, and yet they minimize the need for child care, which is the threshold with which people, mothers and fathers, can go to work if they have that. Do you have any idea of how
that's so important right now? Yesterday I spoke to Andrew Yang, who says the same thing. It's not everything you want,
but you know what?
But there's a lot there.
Honest to God, you really, I can't get over it, because Andrew Yang, he's lovely. Ro Khanna, he's lovely. They are not negotiating this situation. They have no idea of the particulars. They have no idea of what the language is here. I didn't come over here to have, so you're the apologist for the Obama, excuse me. God forbid.
Madam Speaker,
I'm
not
Barack
an apologist.
Obama.
I'm asking you serious questions, because so many people are
I'm
in desperate
to you
need
if we,
right now. Let me ask you this.
Okay.
When was the last time? When was the last time you spoke with the president about this?
I don't speak to the president. Speak
why
with
not?
His,
why
his
not
representative.
Call him? Why not call him and say, Mr. President, let's work out a deal. It's not going to be everything you want, not going to be everything I want. But there are so many Americans right now who are in desperate need. Let's make a deal.
What makes me amused, if it weren't so sad, is how you all think that you know more about the suffering of the American people than those of us who are elected by them to represent them at that table.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is our United States Speaker of the House defending why she will not pass a $1.8 trillion bill for you because it is not good enough. Let me go through a number of the things that she said, and then I'm going to give you my opinion on why this is happening. So first off, one of the interesting things is that Wolf Blitzer brought up the fact that her own Democrat colleagues are telling her to pass this. And not just normal Democrat colleagues. I'm talking about liberal, progressive Democrat colleagues who normally would never agree with anything that the Republicans or the White House would do. They're saying this is a good deal. Nancy Pelosi's response to that is, why are you an apologist for the Republican position? So this is Wolf Blitzer on CNN. And she said some of your colleagues too are apologists for the Republican position. The individuals at CNN are apologists for the Republican position? I mean, has she watched CNN lately at all? And then she went on to say that individuals at the state and local level are going to lose their jobs if we go with the $1.8 trillion bill. Unfortunately for her, there is $300 billion in the White House bill for state and local governments. Not only will the White House's $300 billion offer for state and local government take care of their entire pandemic losses, but it will also pay for a significant portion going into the future. She completely says that there's going to be lost jobs for state and local government, disregarding the $300 billion that's in the White House plan. Then she went on to say that President Donald Trump is refusing to even address this issue. For stimulus needs. Of course, you may think that President Donald Trump is a liar depending on what side you fall on. But no matter what side you fall on, he is definitely not refusing to address this issue. He's tweeting about it every day. He clearly wants to get a bill done. He's sending Steven Mnuchin over there to negotiate and get a deal done. And then Wolf Blitzer called her to task on this and said, there's a $1.8 trillion bill that they're offering to you. What about that? He says, what's wrong with $1.8 trillion? And then Nancy Pelosi goes on to list a number of things that she sees are wrong with it. She starts talking about taxes and tax credits. I mean, in all honesty, tax credits? Tax credits is something you receive one time a year, and it's an insignificant portion. Well, that's what's wrong with their bill. There's not enough tax credits in it. And then she went on to say that they're not helping people who lost their job. There is unemployment boosts in the White House bill. $400 a week unemployment boost. She's flat out lying. She said it's no longer in there to help people who have eliminated their jobs. The problem that I have is I know individuals watch this, and they literally believe what she's saying, even when it's factually incorrect. So she's just straight out lying there. And then as Wolf Blitzer continued to press her on this issue, she went on to say that it was sad and unfortunate that he believes that he knows more about what the American people need than her, because she's been put there. I mean, in all honesty, if you are listening to this channel and you live in California, can you please do everyone a favor and stop voting for Nancy Pelosi? I mean, for goodness sake, California, what are you doing? Do you even watch this? Even if you're a Democrat, do you watch this person? You can agree with many Democrats. Many Democrats you can agree with. You can hear their point of view and understand why they're coming. What in the world is Nancy Pelosi doing? She's got a $1.8 trillion bill in front of her right now that even Republicans in the Senate don't like, but Donald Trump and the White House are willing to negotiate to unbelievable levels after already passing over $3 trillion worth of bills, and she won't take it. So what's going on here, in my opinion, is that Nancy Pelosi is clearly become very frustrated because she is being put to task by her own colleagues. There is mounting pressure on her from her own people to pass this bill, and she's starting to see the negative implications of it, and she's letting that out on Wolf Blitzer's program. However, with all of that said and done, she did in fact still meet with Steven Mnuchin this morning for an hour. After the meeting, Steven Mnuchin gave some statements, and then we also got a little bit from Nancy Pelosi. So this is what we heard. Steven Mnuchin said this: I'd say at this point, getting something done before the election and execution on that would be difficult, just given where we are. And then he was asked if he thought that Democrats were unwilling to make a deal because they did not want to give Donald Trump any sort of a victory before the election. And Mnuchin replied, I think that is definitely part of the reality. That's definitely an issue. I agree with him. What she is doing is not normal. This is a complete political stunt on her end. She doesn't want to pass this bill because she feels like it would be too good for Donald Trump just before an election. And that's a fact. She's completely doing it for that reason because, I mean, it's unbelievably close, these two bills. And there's no reason right now not to help the American people with this bill. Steven Mnuchin continued. He said, I don't agree with the speaker's approach of we have to do all or nothing. We're continuing to negotiate a comprehensive bill, but we want to put money in the economy now. I also agree with that. We have to do all or nothing. And that's my opinion too. Even if you don't think this bill is perfect, so what? Pass it. You're having an election right now. In January and February, you can continue to do more stimulus bills. And that's one of the things that I don't get. Even hardliners who even listen to this channel, who agree with Nancy Pelosi's position, how in the world do you agree with the fact that you can do this $1.8 trillion bill right now and then pick up the negotiations again in a few months to meet any of the additional needs that are there? That is always a possibility, especially after an election that may in fact go in the Democrat way, which would open up that door. But why hold out on the $1.8 trillion in the meantime? It makes no sense. Pelosi's camp came out and simply said there was progress. That is what they said. So what does this mean for the future of the negotiations? Well, because there is mounting pressure on Nancy Pelosi, I think it's going to make it harder and harder for her to not accept this deal. The longer she goes without accepting a $1.8 trillion deal, especially when her own colleagues are calling her out, the worse it's going to look for her. So the best thing she could do right now is try to find a little bit of a sliver more to try and save face, because she's not going to just accept the $1.8 trillion after all of this. But she needs to save face. So maybe Steven Mnuchin and Donald Trump would be willing to offer her a sliver more that she could potentially do that. If they don't, she might in fact actually hold out. And I think this would be a complete detriment to her, her party. And if you're again listening from California, maybe her reelection. Okay, guys, like, listen, I know we're all partisan out there and we have our own bias, but for goodness sake, I mean, Republicans and Democrats alike can agree that what she is doing right now is absolutely ridiculous and really uncalled for when her job is to litigate policy to help the American people, and she is singularly stopping help from the American people. Unbelievable. I hope you got some value out of today's episode. As always, if you have not subscribed to the channel, consider subscribing. I would love to have you come along with me. Once again, I will catch you all next time.